Today I will show you how to install an AutoLev leveling system on your Ender 3. Stay tuned! If you are tired trying to lever your bed with these wheels under the bed, well, this video is for you. We are going to install the AutoLev, the sensor for AutoBed leveling. I will explain in detail how we'll put the AutoLev on the Ender 3, but this sensor can be also applied to another printers. If you like watch videos how to upgrade 3D printers, then subscribe the channel and ring that bell for when I upload the new content, you get a notification so you don't miss anything. Let's talk about the sensor. AutoLev Plus is a capacitive sensor with an excellent quality, for you get the best results on the first layer. Let's see what is in the kit. A sticker, the sensor mount, one AutoLev sensor, and the AutoLev board, zip ties, and power cord to connect the AutoLev on the power supply. Screws and nuts. Now that we have seen what is inside the kit, let's put our parts together. Before starting, unplug the power cord. The first thing I'm going to do is put the sensor in place, and I will show you the easiest way to do it. The first screw to remove is the top one. Now replace the screw with the screw that comes in the kit. I will put now the mount in place. I don't tighten the whole screw. Remove the side screw and change again with that comes in the kit. Now I tighten the two screws and the mount is ready. Now I put the sensor on the mount. It is not important that completely tight. After that I will need to adjust its height in relation to the nozzle and bed. This step is very important. In order for the sensor to be properly assembled, the wire must not be stretched, or the sensor wires will break easily. The wire should have this little loop to protect the wire connector on the sensor. The zip ties should be tightened just enough. It's not necessary to tighten as much as possible. Just adjust them. After putting three zip ties with the wires together with the bowling tube, cut the excess of the zip ties. We put the screws that come with the kit in the box of the AutoLev board. The box of the AutoLev will replace it in the printer frame, so the kit brings these T-nuts. And is ready to put in place. Now we unscrew these two screws to remove the Z-end stop. And unplug the Z-end stop wire. Now we put the AutoLev board in place and tighten the screws to the frame. Let's open the box to see the board. Now we plug the Z-end stop wire to the AutoLev board. Now I will remove these two screws to remove the power supply to connect the power cable to the AutoLev board.
Now we remove these three screws to open the power supply connections. Before connecting the wire, make sure you pass it through the hole at the bottom of the power supply. When you open the power supply, you will see a V plus and V minus. Let's connect the red wire on the V plus. And connect the black wire on the V minus. Close the power supply. Put the power supply in place. And tighten these two screws. Now we lower the nozzle on the Z accumulator until it touches the bed. Then we put this tool that is approximately 2 mm under the sensor and tighten the sensor nuts. This measurement is not necessary to be exactly 2 mm. Just around about 2 mm it's okay. Then lift the nozzle and place the tool under the nozzle. And then move down the nozzle until it touches the tool. Power on the printer. With the screwdriver, we put it on the small screw on the top of the sensor and turn it clockwise until the red light on the sensor turns on. Then we turn in the opposite direction until the light turns off. Then we rotate backwards again until the light's up. And that's it.
Now we have our hardware ready. But remember, on my last video, I explained how to burn a bootloader on my printer. So, my printer has no firmware. Let's download the AutoLev firmware and upload it.
On the AutoLev website, we choose the firmware for our printer, which is in this case Ender 3 or Ender 3 Pro, and we download it. Unzip the firmware. But remember, you can only upload the firmware if you have a bootloader. I will leave in the video description the link to the video explaining how to put the bootloader. Open the unzipped folder and click install, and the AutoLev firmware will open. The firmware will ask you to update, click no. Now connect the USB cable on the printer and we are ready to upload the firmware. Now on the firmware, go to tools and make sure that you have a Sanguino selected and the right COM port and this programmer. Then click upload. This process will take about 5 minutes. When finished, a message will appear, done uploading. Let's power on the printer and the marling is loading. But an error is shown on the screen, EEPROM version. Let's solve this. On the firmware you have a folder called Pronterface. Just open the Pronterface and click connect and send two commands. The first one is M502. The second one is M500. Turn the printer off and turn it on again. And the message Ender 3 ready will appear, instead the error. Now to test the sensor we will make the first auto home. The first times you test the firmware, please be aware and prepare to turn it off the printer in case something goes wrong. But the Z-axis moves upwards instead downwards. Let's fix this. On the auto left board you have this small switch. Just change the switch position. Let's try the auto home again. And to avoid accidents, we will test the sensor by hand, touching it twice. Let's make auto home again to test it. Now I'm prepared to take the test in the bed. And here is the auto home successfully. Now we need to define the Z offset. For that we need to put a sheet of paper under the nozzle. On the printer menu, go to motion, move axis, move Z, and then move 1 mm. And move the Z axis to -1. Go back, go move 0.1 mm. Now move the Z axis until you just feel the nozzle touching the paper sheet. When you feel the nozzle touching the paper sheet, this is our Z offset. Then move axis to 0. Go back. Go to configuration. Go to probe Z offset. And put here the value that you have seen on the move axis, when the nozzle touches the paper sheet. Then start settings and you will hear a beep. And that's it, you have defined your Z offset. Let's make auto home again. Now in the slicer you go to preference, printers, and select your printer. And now after the G28 we add the G29. G29 is the G code for adding auto bed leveling. Now let's load some filament on the printer. Now it's time to check the quality of the first layer that will be leveled by AutoLev system. The sensor will now measure the distance between the nozzle and the bed at various points. Notice how fast is the sensor is taking the measurements twice at each point. Let's make a time lapse. And the sensor is already taking the measurements of 25 points from the bed and save these measurements in variables that will be used by the firmware that will adjust the height of the Z automatically. I usually print an intro line for cleaning the nozzle. Now we will print the test to see if the bed is well leveled. Let's do it! We'll be right back.
Well, what do you think about this upgrade I have done on Ender 3? Leave on the comments below, I want to know your opinion.
Did you like AutoLev? If you want to purchase it, I will leave the link on the video description.
So, this is the end of another episode how to make upgrades on the Ender 3. Don't miss the next one, I will explain how to calibrate the entire machine and I will put the filament sensor using that one that we have removed. If you have liked this video, leave that thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and ring that bell for when I upload the new content, you get a notification. See you at the next one, until there, a big hug to all of you. Bye!